There's something a bit magical about the do-anything nature of a good laptop. You have just enough power, just enough screen, and just enough keyboard to make you master of any domain. A good laptop lures one's mind toward daydreams of saving the day with one's tech prowess and preparedness. However real these dreams may actually be, the magic behind them requires a laptop that can perform both at your desk and on the road, all with a little bit of style. There are only a few real contenders to begin with, and when price plays a role, as it often does with me, that list narrows further. Ultimately, I went with the Asus Zephyrus G14. One of those new 4000 series AMD mobile CPUs was a must, and the G14 builds a very good, but not perfect package around that amazing Ryzen 9 4900HS. The exterior of the G14 is attractive, though a bit unconventional. One big plus is that there's no large Asus branding anywhere. I'm not a fan of their branding, so limiting it to the small silver badge is a big win to me. The tiny holes on the laptop lid, I don't have the version with the lights, give it a unique look that adds some nice geometry to the lid. I could see not liking them as they are attention grabbing, but they don't bother me. The rest of the G14 exterior is pretty nice, with the silver unibody base that reminds me a lot of an early 2010s 13-inch MacBook Pro, but with much more aggressive vents for cooling. The keyboard also reminds me of an older MacBook Pro, but kind of mixed with a modern ThinkPad where it's a bit more of a snappy response. It's a phenomenal keyboard, except for the less than effective backlighting, with a mercifully standard layout, very easy to get up to speed on. Sticking with the exterior, the one area where the G14 lets me down is with the layout of the ports, which are all squished in the front middle of the sides of the laptop. I suppose this has to do with making room for the excellent cooling solution, but it creates an unusual untidiness. In practice, it isn't as annoying as I'd feared, but I wish they'd found a way to put them in their traditional locations. Aside from that, the ports are quite good. You get two USB-C ports, one that does charging and display, two USB-A ports, a headphone jack, a full-size HDMI port, and of course the barrel plug charging port that's standard for any high-powered gaming laptop. The only nice-to-have port that's missing is Ethernet. Speaking of networking, I'm getting about 250 to 400 megabits per second over Wi-Fi with the G14, though those less than impressive speeds could be partially down to my aging AC1200 router. This does have Wi-Fi 6, so a Wi-Fi 6 router might be able to do better. I've been using it extensively as well with Bluetooth headphones, and they've maintained a strong connection throughout my apartment, only losing connection when I get about 50 feet away. Performance is excellent for a laptop that you can so easily slip into a backpack. The Ryzen 9 4900HS performs extremely well in multimedia, productivity, and gaming tasks, while also flexing its multi-core muscle when you let it. One example of this multi-core might that I've taken advantage of is recording game footage in open broadcasting software, also known as OBS. Like the 12-core Ryzen 9 desktop the G14 replaced for me, I can record steady 60 FPS footage of AAA games like Assassin's Creed Valhalla using software rendering, so that's all on the CPU, with no hiccups. It's incredible to have that kind of power in such a portable laptop. You won't be able to play every game at max settings, but I haven't had to work hard to get great frame rates in everything I've thrown at it. But that power doesn't make this like shoving a jet engine into a Mini Cooper. When you unplug the G14 and go mobile, it can sit battery for legitimately 9 to 10 hours when just writing, web browsing, and watching videos. One caveat to this battery life is that I've found I often have to reboot the laptop in order to achieve it, as the graphics fail to automatically switch over to the integrated Radeon graphics until that reboot occurs. Fortunately, the G14 is a fast machine, so the reboots don't take long, but it would be nice if they could fix whatever bug causes that. Still, the G14 does stay very cool and quiet for mobile use, and even when I don't reboot and it still kinda uses the dedicated graphics or is triggering them, I'm still getting about 5 to 6 hours in those cases. Heat on the G14 is noticeable under heavy loads, particularly on the right side of the keyboard next to the exhaust vent. I'm not sure it ever really crosses the line from very warm all the way to hot, though. The Ryzen 4900 HS CPU does run actually almost weirdly cool during light tasks, though this could be because the default profiles keep the fans running at all times. So even when it's running at 28 or 30 degrees Celsius, which is actually pretty normal in the 30s for me, it still has those fans running. So you'll probably want to set a custom fan curve if you're going to be doing sort of light work on this regularly. I have made a couple of upgrades to the G14, installing a 2TB Corsair MP510 SSD and upgrading the RAM from 16GB to 24GB. Those are the only upgrades available, the RAM and the SSD, with only one RAM slot being available since 8GB is soldered onto the motherboard. I was initially concerned about the performance impact of going from dual-channel memory to single-channel, but the loss of CPU performance has seemed quite low thus far. In Cinebench R20, for example, the score only changed from 4138 to 4103 when switching from 16GB of dual-channel memory to 24GB of single-channel memory. I plan to investigate this deeper later on, but so far it doesn't seem performance impact is as big as I'd worried. Moving to the outside again, the lack of a webcam seems like a dumb omission, but I'd mostly use the webcam at my desk anyway, where I already have a dedicated webcam set up on my external monitor, so maybe that's what Asus was thinking, that G14 buyers would already have a webcam. There's not really much else to say about that, it seems kinda dumb. The speakers are quite good. They have good bass for a laptop this size, and get loud enough to overpower the fans easily without distorting. They're the best laptop speakers I've ever used outside of laptops I've tested in the store, but you know, I haven't had a recent model MacBook Pro, which those have amazing speakers, but they're really good laptop speakers. They're good. You won't be disappointed. The overall package of the G14 is hard to top. If you can live with the software issues I mentioned, this is the first Windows laptop I've used that can give you the type of experience Apple has offered with their larger MacBook Pros for years. Good build quality and a portable design with the power to get you through whatever you need to do and the ability to last all day long on the battery. There are definitely some rough edges to the G14, like that front and center I/O, the weirdly shaped power button / fingerprint reader, which works great for me by the way, and the slightly unrefined elements like those vents. But those are all a small price to pay for a laptop that takes the first step toward that techie fantasy of saving the day with their awesome gear. Well, as long as that gear doesn't include a built-in webcam. Anyway, thanks for watching this video. I hope it was helpful. If you have any questions about the G14, feel free to leave a comment, and I'll do the best I can to help you out. Have a good one.